A TSBVI Outreach Tutorial. APH Braille Print Protractor, Part 6. Drawing a Print 70-Degree Angle, and its Supplement. Presented by Susan Osterhaus, a Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach Math Consultant.
Okay, so now we're going to draw, of course, a different angle because the teacher's going to ask you to draw more than just a 90-degree angle. This time we're going to draw a 70-degree angle. We're going to use the same techniques. I'm going to start, I think, from this side and probably do more tactily than visually. I'm going to come up and I'm going to notice I've got that 45, then maybe 50, 55, 60, 65, 70. So there's my 70 degrees. I can also look visually. There's that 70 degrees, maybe back off with the wand a little bit. And see, that's another thing is this kind of, the wand kind of covers up the 70. So it's kind of nice to have that tactile dots to kind of line up with the pointed part of your wand. Okay, so you've now formed, you have found the 70, you've tightened, but now you have to turn upside down. And here you're going to have a bit of a dilemma. Uh-oh. Is it this side or the other side that's a 70 degrees? Well, hopefully your student has already had instruction and knows that a 70 degree angle is an acute angle, which means it is less than 90 degrees, greater than 0 degrees and less than 90 degrees. So looking visually or helping, you know, with going ahead and checking it tactually, they have figured out that this side, the right side, is the correct side to go ahead and draw the 70-degree angle. So again, I'm going to hold it very firmly. Now you're going to notice my technique has changed slightly because of the angle. So now I seem to be holding the wand actually with a little bit less, maybe only one finger. And it's going to change with me. It's going to change with your students as well. But again, you just get that pen and go straight in. They're going to be able to feel it hitting there in case they don't have very good vision. And then they're going to, after they've hit that, they're going to continue. I'm going to go ahead and go back over that a little bit. And we now have that 70 degree angle. Again, they may choose to go ahead and put arrows and to call this 70 degrees. Now, while they were at it, though, a lot of my students, when they're working on this, they go, you know, Miss O, I'd like to draw the angle over here, the supplement, because I think that's kind of neat. Now, for me, because I'm right-handed, it's going to be very awkward. I'm going to just try to show you how awkward it would be for me to try to get around like this and draw this. So I'm going to turn this, and this is fine. Your students can turn this any way they feel comfortable. So I'm going to try to keep my angle about at 70. I'm going to make sure that I haven't moved that wand. And I'm going to actually draw that other angle with a different technique. Notice now my wand is being held by my thumb and the rest of my hand is holding the protractor. So it's just a little bit different the way you hold it. And probably it's going to come more naturally to me to start on the edge of the protractor and then go up the wand, but I could have gone the other direction. I'm just showing you as many techniques as I can to let you know that none of them are wrong if they work, as long as they work. So let's see, did it work? It certainly did, and we'll come back and put it the way we're a little more used to looking at it. And we already talked about the fact that these two angles are supplements. This is 70 degrees. Its supplement would be 180 degrees minus 70 degrees, so this should be 110 degrees. And again, we might put some arrows and we would put our name at the top and we have something to hand in to the teacher. Now, I'm waiting for somebody to say something because, and of course, no one has yet, so I'm going to speak up and say, you might have a student that the ballpoint pen is not their favorite pen, and so you can use another type of pen. Let's just go ahead and keep this these same measurements. I know that this is probably not your student's favorite, but they probably like a 20-20 or something like that. But this happens to be a Sharpie permanent marker, which smells terribly, but just to prove to you that something like this works as well. Again, you're going to hold it, whatever technique you want, and you've got, whoops, did I go far enough? Yep. You have that nice angle. You can put your arrows on if you so desire. Let me go back and do that same other supplementary angle. I'm going to move it around just because that's my technique. Again, holding it. Now look at this, see, I'm gonna even use a different technique. But the big thing is to be careful and not get your fingers in the drawing area. That's the biggie. So again, if your students prefer a little bit different, a little bit thicker type of pen, it works for that as well. So just and of course we would go ahead and add the degrees and so forth. Whatever your student prefers, whatever type of pen, ballpoint, Sharpie, 2020, pencil, go ahead and let them try it. Whatever their favorite pen is, it should work out just beautifully for them.
This video continues in the TSBVI Outreach Tutorial Series, APH Braille Print Protractor. Look for other videos by Susan Osterhaus on math for the blind and visually impaired. APH is American Printing House for the Blind. A TSBVI Outreach Distance Learning Production. Executive Producers, William Daugherty, Superintendent. Cyril Miller, Outreach Director. Outreach Producers, Susan Osterhaus, Math Consultant. Mike Bicknell, Media Specialist. Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach Program. 1100 West 45th Street, Austin, Texas 78756, USA. Telephone, 512-454-8631. Website, www.tsbvi.edu. Video copyright TSBVI 2009, all rights reserved.